to the video tutorial series of the wireless communication. I am your instructor Varsha Tam. Let's start our today's lecture series. So at the end of this video, you will be able to learn about what is the direct sequence spread spectrum and example on the direct sequence spread spectrum. So let's start with the direct sequence spread spectrum. In last lecture, we have learned about the frequency hopping spread spectrum. Okay, so let's learn about what is the direct sequence spread spectrum. Now all of you were about what is the spread spectrum technology. Okay, so let's start with the direct sequence spread spectrum. Every user assigns a special code. That code is used to encode the signal. Okay, so here you can see the XOR is the technique. All of you were about the XOR because you have learned that thing in the digital digital subject. Okay, so XOR technique is used to combine the data stream with a cheap sequence code that is known as the spread code. Okay, so here this cheap sequence code produced by the transmitter are already known to the receiver. Okay, so this code is already known to the receiver. Why? Because if this code is not known to the receiver, then how the receiver will decode the signals? So that's why this cheaping sequence is known to everyone. And receiver spread the signal. That means receiver can decode the signals. Okay, the receiver will use the same chipping sequence to reconstruct the information signal. Okay, so whatever the information signals you have sent, so that signals will be decoded by the receiver using that the same chipping sequence. To get the original signal, we need the XOR the signal. So XOR or doing the XOR again, you will get the original input. So that is the property of the XOR. That's why we are using this XOR in this direct sequence spread spectrum. Now the DSS receiver is a more complex than the transmitter. Why? The pseudo random sequence at the sender and receiver have to be precisely synchronized. Not any single bit change is variable in this DSS. Because the receiver calculates the product of the chip with the incoming signals, that's why. During a bit period, which also has to be derived via synchronization, and integrated adds all the products. Okay, so calculating the products of the chips and the digital and the signals and the adding the products in the integrated is also called the correlations, and the device is called the connector. Okay, so that is known as the this process is known as the correlation, and the device what is which is doing this thing, that is known as the connector. Now what are the features of the DSS? Let's learn. First one is what? It provides the good security against the potential jamming of the interpretation. Okay, so for against the jamming of the signals, it provides the security. Then extremely effective against the narrowband signals. You know that this spread spectrum, that means what? You are converting the broadband signal to the narrowband, so it can be transmitted easily. That's why. Very effective against the broadband interference. Okay, and it's now what are the disadvantages of this? Let's see. First one is what? It increased the bandwidth. Okay, it increased the bandwidth. Then need for broad PN, that is a pseudo random sequence. Then synchronization is affected by the variable distance between the transmitter and the receiver. Okay, so these are the advantages and disadvantages of this direct sequence spread spectrum. Why we are using this direct sequence spread spectrum? Now, which are the applications of this direct sequence spread spectrum? Where it is used? Okay, so first one is it is used for the jamming the signal. Okay, so if you want to jam the signal, so at that time also this spread spectrum technique is used. Sometimes you know there's some disasters are there. So at that time this signals is jammed. So jamming for the jamming signals we used. Then military communications, then the cordless phone, then digital cellular telephony, then we are using the for the satellite navigation, then wireless LAN technology, different types of wireless LAN technologies are there. Okay, so for that also we are using that, for example, Bluetooth technology, then Wi-Fi technology, in which we are using this direct sequence spread spectrum technology. Okay, so these are the applications of the direct sequence spread spectrum. Now let's see the block diagram of this. So first is transmitter. What transmitter will do? So first of all, here you can see the user data that is known as the MT, that is transmitted to the this X box, that is what? The chipping sequence. Okay, this that is XORed, and here the chipping sequence is added to the user data. So chipping sequence and user data will be XORed. Now this will become the spread spectrum signal, and the signal that is white is equal to empty CT that will be going to the modulator, and at the modulator radio carrier signals will be added, and after that this modified signals will be transmitted. So that will be received by the receiver. Now what receiver will do? Okay, so here receiver receive the signals. Now here we have used the modulator, so at the receiver side we have to use the demodulator because we are doing encoding and decoding, that's why. Okay, so demodulator, again the radio carrier signals is added to that particular signals, and this particular signals, after adding the radio carrier signals, it will given to the correlator. Okay, so where XORed will be done again with the chipping sequence, and this products will be given to the integrated. Okay, so it will sampled it and it will define the final decision, that means it will give the final output. So that will be the original data that will be received by the receiver, so receiver can understand it because now it is demodulated. Got it? So here the modulation and demodulations will be done in the direct sequence spread spectrum while transmitting and the receiving the signal. Now let's see one example on the CDMA network, so you will have the better idea about how this direct sequence spread spectrum works. Okay, so in a CDMA network, assume that there are two stations. One station is A and another station is B, and for this station A, the chipping sequence is given to you that you can see on the screen, that is 0001011. And for this station B, the chipping sequence is given to you, that is 0010110. Okay, now here you can see the figure one show two cases of the both station transmitting at the same time. Okay, these two stations are transmitting at the same time. So what we have to calculate, so show the transmitted sequences S1 and S2 and how DSSS does the recovery at the receiver, that means how the signals will be demodulated at the receiver side. This is very simple example, but very complex procedures will be done while this DSS will transmit the signal and while the signals is demodulated. Okay, so we will see the basic method how this signals is demodulated and modulated. So let's see here in this figure, the two station is given, that is A and B. Okay, and here in this first signal you can see A1 and 0, that means A send 1 and B send 0, that will be your first signal. In the second signal you can see A send 0 and B is ideal. So only A sent 0 is there. Now let's see how this sum will be calculated and how we can decode at the receiver side, how the receiver will decode the signals. Okay, so here you can see this is the signal S1, as I told you, and this is the signal S2. Okay, and here let's see the vector representation. 0, that means what? The minus 1, and 1, that means plus 1. Okay, so first of all, convert the chipping sequence into the vector form. What you have to done? You first of all, you have to convert this chipping sequence into vector form. So vector represent as, that means what? 0, that means minus 1, and 1, that means plus 1. So like this way, you have to convert the entire sequence into vector representation. So here you can see the A, first line you can see A, the chipping sequence for the A is 0001011, in which you can see the transformation is done A. After that, 0 is converted to the minus 1, again the 0 is converted to the minus 1, again the 0 is converted to the minus 1. After that, 1 is there, so it is plus 1. Then again 1 is there, so it is plus 1. After that, 0 is there, so it is minus 1. And after that, 2 times 1 is there, so it is plus 1 and plus 1. Got it? Like this way, we are going to convert the B chipping sequence for station B also, where you have to represent the 0 as a minus 1 and 1 as a plus 1. Got it? Then now let's see, first we have to find out the signal S1 and S2. Okay, that will be done at the transmitter side because transmitter is transmitting the signal, that's why. Okay, so here you can see the signal S1. What is signal S1? Here where A and B both are transmitting. A is transmitting 1 and B is transmitting 0. So the formula will become S1 is equal to A plus B bar, or we can say B dashed. Okay, so A plus B bar. So what you have to do? The chipping sequence is given to you for the station A and B. Now here A is as it is, so we don't have to change anything the chipping in any digits of the chipping sequence. You just have to write as it is, as you have converted at the upper side. So here you can see A, after that we have defined minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, that is same as that we have converted it. Now plus B bar, or we can say B dash. So what we have to do? So for that we are taking this B as exactly reverse of the original. So here the original chipping sequence is what? Minus 1 for B, that is minus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1, plus 1, plus 1 and minus 1. So you have to take exactly reverse of this. So what is this? Plus 1, plus 1, here minus 1, plus 1, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1 and the plus 1. Now what you have to do? You have to add these two signals, two chipping sequence to form the S1 signal. So now when we are adding this chipping sequences, so here you can see for A and B, minus 1, C at the first digit in each and every chipping sequence in this A plus B. So minus 1 and plus 1, what is that? 0. Minus 1 and plus 1, again what is that? 0. Minus 1 and minus 1, what is that? Minus 2. Plus 1 and plus 1, that is plus 2. Again minus 1 plus 1, 0. Minus 1 minus 1, minus 2. Plus 1 minus 1, 0 and plus 1 plus 1, plus 2. So like this way we are able to find out this S1 signal. Okay, so here we have find it out the S1 signal, which is going to be transferred in the air and it will be received by the receiver. Now let's see over here, again we are defining the signal as 2. Okay, so here again the converting chipping sequence is given to you, that is same as the previous slide. Now here for the signal S2, what is that in the figure? Just A is transmitting, B is silent. Okay, just A is transmitting. So here you can see the S2 is equal to A dash because A is transmitting. But again, A is transmitting 0. Got it? A is transmitting 0. So that's why what we have to do? We have to take exactly reverse of the chipping sequence of the A. Okay, so here A is equal to A dash, in which we have to take the reverse of this chipping sequence. That is, you can see over here in the first line, minus 1, minus 1, minus 1, plus 1, plus 1, minus 1, plus 1 and plus 1. So we are taking the exactly reverse, that is plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, minus 1, minus 1, likewise. So what will be our S2 signal? So that is plus 1, plus 1, plus 1, minus 1, minus 1, plus 1, minus 1 and minus 1. Got it? Now let's see converting this two at the receiver side. Okay, so receiver side, what will happen? How we are able to decode these signals? So again, the converting chipping sequence, that is same that we are seeing in the each and every slides. Now here at the receiver side, the station A and signal S1. You have to define the pair. Two stations are there. Two signals are there. AS1, BS1. AS2, BS2, likewise you have to calculate. Okay, so first let's find out S1A. Okay, so here S1A, that is again you have to define the S1 signals that we have sent to the receiver. So this, it will be received by the receiver, and chipping sequence is already known to the receiver. Okay, so this two thing is there with the receiver. So now what receiver will do? Receiver this, multiply these things and find it out the output. So here you can see when we are multiplying the signal S1 and A. So 0 minus 1, 0, 0 minus 1, 0, minus 2 minus 1, that is plus 2. Because we are doing the multiplication, that's why. Okay, plus 2 plus 1, that is again plus 2. So likewise, we are doing the multiplication. After that, after completing the multiplication, what you have to do? You have to add all these digits. So here 0 plus 0 plus 2 plus 2, then plus 0 plus 2 plus 0 plus 2. Remember one thing. Every time you will get the output 8 plus 8 minus 8 or 0. Got it? Every time you will get the output plus 8 minus 8 or 0. Rest of the output, if you are getting, then your sum is wrong. Okay, so here 8 by 8. Now our chipping sequence is the size of the 8. So what we are doing, we are dividing it with the 8 by 8. Okay, then 8 by 8, that means it's 1, 8, 1, 7. So we have the output plus 1. So now what is the meaning of this? Plus 1, that means bit 1 was sent by the station A in signal S1. Got it? Same way, at the receiver side, we have to define the S1B. So in S1 signal, what B has sent? So again, you have to write that down, the S1 signal and then the chipping sequence of the B. And you have to multiply this. And after adding this, you will get the minus 8. And now you have to divide it by the 8. So it will you will get the answer minus 1. So minus 1, that means vector representation, bit 0 is sent. Okay, so we get the exact thing that we have sent in the signal as well. Okay, so B has sent the 0 in the signal S1. Likewise, you have to find out S2A, and same way you have to find out S2B. Okay, so here S2B is ideal, that's why I have not shown in this slide. Okay, so likewise you can find it out all the signal, all the information that is sent in the signal by the stations. Now here this is the practice example. Here in the CDMA network, assume that there are 4 stations. We have taken the example with the 2 stations. Now you have to take the examples with the 4 stations. Okay, so this 4 stations examples and everything is written in this. 4 station chipping sequence is given to you. And here the information is also given to you in which signal, which stations have signed what information. So here you can see in the horizontal line dash dash 1 and dash. So that means what? Only C has sent the 1 bit. So here your S1 signal will be just C. Okay, the chipping sequence of the C that you are going to convert, that is minus 1 plus 1 minus 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1 and minus 1. That is C. So your signal S1 will become like this. Same way you have to find out the S2. That is what? B plus C. Because A and D is ideal. After that, the S3 signal, that is A plus B bar, and S4 signal A plus B plus C bar plus D. Likewise, you have to find out the 4 signals at the transmitter side, and then you have to define S1 dot A, S1 dot B, S1 dot C, S1 dot D. Likewise. Okay, so the sum is for the practice for you. So do it. So in this video lecture, we have learned about what is the direct sequence spread spectrum, and then we have learned the example on the DSS. One we have done and one is for you for the practice. Okay, so thank you for watching. We will meet in the next lecture with a new topic. Thank you.